Hey Vanna students, it's Mackenzie here bringing you week three of our series called Waitlisted, where we've been talking about what it feels like to wait. What kind of disappointments or hurts we may be experiencing while we're waiting. Last week we talked about how even in the time of waiting, God is faithful. This week we're going to be talking about what listening has to do with waiting. Have you ever been listening to someone tell a story or make a point, but you suddenly realize you stop listening and you haven't heard a thing that they were saying? Maybe that's happening to you right now. I think we're all guilty of this, and even if we don't want to admit it, everyone likes to be listened to, but the problem that we face is that everybody likes to talk too. What is cool about God is He is the best listener and He can listen to us ramble for days. Sometimes life seems like one thing is piling on top of another, and if the memes of 2020 explain anything about the way that people are feeling these days, it is that we are fed up, exhausted, disappointed in more ways than one, and just overall done. Whether you're wrestling with doubt or experiencing tragedy or walking through difficult circumstances, it is understandable if you question if God is still listening to you. There's someone in Scripture who asks the same types of questions. His name is David, and he's one of the most famous figures from the Old Testament of the Bible. He's the David from David and Goliath. But we're getting ahead of ourselves. We're going to break down the story of David into scenes that are kind of like a play, okay? So scene one, David is chosen as king. When David was a young boy in the land of Israel, a man named Saul was king. Although God had originally chosen Saul to be king of Israel, Saul's actions had caused him to lose God's blessing and God's favor, which means it's not good. God was on the lookout for a new king, and God found the new king in David, a young shepherd boy. Because David was so young, small, and unassuming, he was almost overlooked, but God saw him. God sent the prophet Samuel to anoint David with oil, symbolizing that David would one day become king, which is pretty awesome, actually. It's a pretty awesome promise that you're going to be king. But what God didn't tell David at the time was that David would need to wait for that promise to be fulfilled. And the waiting, it would be really difficult. So scene two, David defeats Goliath. Later, King Saul's armies were being attacked by their enemies, the Philistines, including a giant man named Goliath. No one wanted to fight Goliath, but David was up for the challenge. Trusting God would be with him, David faced off against this Philistine warrior, holding only a single slingshot and a few rocks. And David won. Scene three, Saul gets jealous. At King Saul's request, David begins hanging around Saul. David was a talented musician, so Saul would ask David to play him some songs on his harp. But this relationship didn't last. Soon, Saul began growing jealous of David. He couldn't stand how much everyone loved David and how talented he was, or how he seemed to have God's favor. Remember, Saul didn't have God's favor. So Saul grew so angry that he tried to kill David by throwing spears at him. Scene four, Saul versus David. Things got so bad that David fled the kingdom while Saul and his men hunted and continued trying to kill him. Saul's men chased David from city to city, and there were a few close encounters, but David stayed safe from Saul's attacks. Remember how rough David's waiting is? This is why it's so rough. Scene five, David becomes king. It's a long and dramatic story, and you can read it in the book of 1 Samuel in the Bible, but let's fast forward to the fulfillment of God's promise to make David king. Saul eventually dies in battle, and when he did, David was made king and was no longer waiting for God's promise to be fulfilled. David's path to the throne wasn't what he had planned or what he wanted, but here's the amazing thing. During more than 15 years of waiting on that promise, which 15 years is longer than some of you have even been alive, David never stopped talking to God. He talked to God when he was lonely. He talked to God when he was surrounded by enemies. He talked to God when he was discouraged. He talked to God when he was angry and when he was desperate. And this isn't even where David's story ends. Even after he became king, there are so many moments in David's life when he cried out to God and God heard him every single time. You can find all of David's story in 1 and 2 Samuel and the beginning of 1 Kings. You can also read an account of David in 1 Chronicles. And I love reading of David, and one specific reason I love reading of David is because over and over and over again in Scripture, we read of David inquiring of the Lord. Whenever he has to make a decision, or he's upset, or he's even happy, Scripture repeatedly tells us that David inquired of the Lord and that he sought the Lord. This is seen in 1 Samuel 23:2, 1 Samuel 23:4, 1 Samuel 30:8, 2 Samuel 2:1, 2 Samuel 5:23, 2 Samuel 21:1, 1 Chronicles 14:10, and 1 Chronicles 14:14. And I'm sure I missed some of these, and there's different ways of saying that David went to the Lord, but I feel like we can learn a lot from this. While David waited for God to fulfill that promise, he chose to trust in God's faithfulness. And while he waited, David never stopped talking to God, because David knew, while we're waiting, God is listening. So keep talking, because God is listening. Why are you waiting on God? Like David, are you waiting for God to fulfill a promise? Are you waiting for a prayer to be answered? Do you feel like you're surrounded by enemies? Do you need guidance about what step to take next? Are you feeling lonely, afraid, overwhelmed, angry, or discouraged? When you're waiting on God for whatever reason, God never stops listening, so just keep talking. In Psalm 116, David said God's ear turns towards us when we pray. Imagine that. So here are two things that you can do when you've got God's ear. The first one is share your situation. God knows exactly what you're going through right now, but that doesn't mean God doesn't want to talk with you about it. When you pray, tell God what's happening. No matter why you have been waiting on God this week, practice praying about it. The second thing is share your feelings. My favorite part of David's Psalms are how honest they are. He poured out all his emotions to God, and you can do the same. Your feelings, even the ones you think might be ugly or embarrassing, don't intimidate or surprise God. So don't be afraid. While David waited on God, God never stopped listening, and David never stopped praying. So let's keep praying, because while we're waiting, God is listening to us too. Manna students, we want to talk about this further with you. We also want to pray with you in our small group. So if you're at one of our student site groups, we're going to go ahead and do that now through our small group questions and small group time. If you are watching this online, you can find our small group questions below for some thought and some interaction there. Also, if you need anything to be prayed for you, please let us know. We would love to be praying with you. See you next week.